Getting into stores right now as this video goes live is MPC's 1/25th scale Golden Hawk Special Edition Jeep CJ. This is a pretty cool machine. It's got the awesome retro features on there. I'm not exactly sure, but I think this was the kit that was the base for the Daisy Duke Jeep back in the day. And that's why I'm going to go with the color scheme that I'm going with. Whether it's a perfect replica of that model back then or not, that's what I want to go with because that's the look that I enjoyed. I think her Jeep was a Golden Eagle. Is what they called it back in the day, and it had different hood emblems and stuff like that, but we can still build it up to look like a cool version of it and have fun. Let me open up the box and show you all the cool stuff that's inside. First up are these retooled Desert Dog PCV, the Formula tires. They've been using these for years, but like the last build we did with these tires, it looks like they've retooled them, made them more crisp, brought them back. They're nice and hollow. They will fit over the tire, the wheels, and you can build those up. You get 5 in the box, so you can definitely replicate having the spare hanging off the back, which is pretty usual for a Jeep. Then we've got a clear parts tree, we've got a red transparent parts tree, and we've got a clear soft top. We'll take a look at the clear parts here. We've got our windshield. We've also got a rounded windshield for another version. So we've got square and round. I think this one must take the one with the, I'm not really sure. We'll let the instructions tell me. And then we've got our round headlights and our signal marker lights. And those are nice and crystal clear. We've got this cool clear top. What you'd have to do if you want to use this is mask off the glass. You can see where it's indented. And then it's got a texture to it. So you would mask it off and then spray the rest of it to make it opaque. The side windows are almost impossible to tell where they are. You can see them a little bit on this side, but not so much on this side. So what you'd want to do is use this side as kind of a template, or just roughly make your tape squares off there, wherever you guessed it, kind of a small slant, and you'll look just fine. It's a Jeep, so they're not going to be perfect anyways. We've got our transparent red taillights. Then we've got a nice chrome tree. It's got a set of 5 wagon wheels. We've got some auxiliary lights. We've got engine parts in chrome, like a fan, air cleaner, alternator. The alternator actually has a bracket on this one, the distributor. I'm gonna end up gluing all these parts together because I don't want chrome on this. And then we've got our side mirrors, so be very careful. We've got our shift lever, our four-wheel drive shift lever. This looks like a nice large tachometer right there. So we've got a bunch of small chrome parts, which should work out well. Got these long pieces right here. Must be our bumpers. What else we got in the box on this side of the table? We've got the nice, beautiful decal sheet. Includes gauge clusters. Includes the Golden Hawk emblems. Nice license plates with Utah. Has numerous Jeeps, so if you don't want to use all the stuff that's in here, you can use the different colored Jeep emblems to paint any color Jeep you want. They've got the Jeep logos. They like the AMC Jeep logos. CJ5 logos. What else? We got the Renegade logos. So if you want to do a Renegade Jeep in 2 colors, the Golden Hawk, we got the blue on there. We've got some nice hood striping with the side stripes down the side. So yeah, pretty extensive for factory badging on there. Nice to see all of that. Let's get over to the styrene. On this tree here, we will have the firewall. We've got our windshield frame, which looks like it's got kind of the rounded windshield on this one. We've got our roll bar. We've got our, I think these are side steps if you wanted to use them. Yeah, that's what those are. Side steps. If you wanted to use those, of course you don't have to. Just because they're on the tree doesn't mean you got to use them. We've got our nice Jeep hood. I love the little open hinges back here. Got our cowl and our open hinges. Got all of our rubber bracing. Got our steelies if you want to do steel wheels on this one. Got our wheel back. So, yep, we got our standard Jeep steering wheel. Check out the adorable little grille, and it's molded open, which is, you know, surprising for a kit of this era. We've got some nice fender flares on there, which will let you paint them separately instead of trying to paint them on the vehicle. We've got our exhaust manifold. We've got a sport steering wheel. We've got, looks like the military style dashboard, but it could be the stock dashboard. I'm not really sure. We've got some hinges here. We've got some braces for the top. I like the fender flares on there. Those are cool. Get those painted up. On this tree here, we've got some entrenching tools. We got an axe. We've got parts of the machine gun for the military version. We've got our bucket seats, spare wheel cover, all different little pieces and accessories. We got the gas tanks. You're going to have parts left over. Got a little CB radio. Then we've got our rear seat. We've got our radiator. Got the other half of the spare tire cover. Got our military back seat. Our more utilitarian parts on there. Got a long steering column. And then we've got our little four banger. Inline four. Got our fan there if you don't want to dress it up. Beautiful looking shocks. Got our solid axles. Got our leaf spring setups. I do like seeing that it's got the holes in it so that we can set them up on the axles without having things go wiggity whack. Oil pan, belt, and pulley system. Even a starter on there. Then we've got our CJ body. Pretty sweet looking. It's got all little rivets along the side. Got our basic floor pan. Got all of our little metal work and all that molded in the floor. Underneath, we can see it's even got the ribs on the bottom. It's got locators for the frame, exhaust. And then we've got our frame. And it's molded straight, tip it upside down. It's not moving around. Nice and solid. It's not tweaked or warped. So we should be able to build a relatively straight Jeep with my skills on here. And that is sharp looking. So I'm going to start gluing my Golden Hawk together, and I'll be right back. Okay, take a peek at what we got going on. So there's parts I left off that I can assemble later, and then there's whole sub-assemblies. I've never seen Jeeps with anything but an entire black frame, axles and everything. And I want to do the white and gold theme as we saw in the thumbnail. So this actually builds up nicely. Now, in that video of me assembling, you, those of you with a good eye caught me actually doing it backwards. I started to put the front axle and springs on the rear, this being the rear. So I just had to gently pry the glued parts off and put it back, and we're sitting on all four tires. I didn't screw it up too bad, but yeah, I did put it on there, and the minute I realized it, I'm like, oh man, they're gonna be going silly in the comments. And you can tell because you gotta put the drag link in here on the steering box and everything, and you've got your motor mounts in the front. So it's just, you know, been a long weekend. I've been outside a lot of sun. So forgive me, everyone makes mistakes, but it goes together nicely. The shocks go on there beautifully, and we have a nice structure there that our cute little four-cylinder will bolt into. We got our oil filter, we've got our distributor and our starter, and our carburation, we got our valve cover, cylinder head, we got that nice manifold on there. We've even got a little fuel pump. So if you wanted to use this to power other vehicles, you could do so. And that will end up dropping in. We'll get the exhaust under there, and then that motor mount will drop in there. We've got our itty bitty drive shafts to go from the transfer case, and from the transfer case to the rear end, transfer case to the front end. So we're gonna be able to get that all together without problems. You can see how nice that fits in there. We'll get that all painted up and glued in, and then we can drop our body on towards the end. I wanna do black fender flares, because I looked up the Jeep on the TV show, and it's got black fender flares. So we'll paint those, then we'll get those installed. I'm gonna paint these with a flat black, and I won't try to gloss them or anything. We'll get them on there. We've got our wheel backs all done. Those are set up. I have to paint the wheels, so I haven't glued those to the wheel backs yet, but we'll get there. But I got to paint those and get those on. And then we've got our steering. This is the steering column they tell you to use. So that's the one that I will use with the basic steering wheel. We've got our radiator and shroud, and that will go in, and that will attach to the back of the grill. We've got our complete exhaust system. Can get that painted up a metallic color. On the tree with the drive shafts and the radiator hose, we've got our air cleaner assembled, and then we've got our generator and our fan on there. And those are ready to go because I'm just using the stock stuff. I'm not using the fancy stuff. This part here is our skid plate for under the transfer case, so I will paint that a metallic color. We've got the parking brake on the Jeep. That just was a separate piece that I ended up cutting off by mistake and realized I needed it for that. We've got our two bucket seats in the front with our backs that glue on. Those we will glue in when we get them all painted. Same with the rear seat. Well, she had a rear seat on that one because one of the Duke boys would always have to ride in the back and then jump onto Roscoe's car, or someone stole the General Lee or something like that. So we'll make sure that that's on there. And then we can move the body over. And you can see that I've got the rear roll bar all set up. You have to drill out the holes if you're going to use the roll bar. And then we've got that glued together, and that's ready to go. And then on mine, I'm not going to try to fold the windshield or anything, so I put the hinges and everything, and then I'm not going to be using the top, but I used the top to make sure I had the windshield at the correct angle. And that will go on there. The top does fit beautifully. If you decide to use it, look at the fit on that. I mean, I'm even shaking the car and it's not falling off. So the top will fit on there quite nice. I never saw the show with it up because they always had to do some cool stunts. Plus, you'd get a better view of Daisy as she goes by. On the back of the Jeep, we've got our spare tire hanger installed, and that'll just go right in the middle. We've got our dashboard installed behind our windshield. We've got our seat mounts right there. Those might even be fuel tanks in the real world. I'm not too familiar with the CJ5s. The hood goes on easily, goes right into its hinges, and I'm only leaving it on the tree so I can paint it up, but look at that, it's going to pop right into those hinges without a problem. Once we get that tree cut off, it'll fit in there without raising itself up. The grill fits in. Since we'll be taking the body and lowering it over, we can do that pretty easy. Drop it on there, and then I can glue in the radiator mount and everything, and we'll have that fit on there without a problem. The grill just drops in. I also glued in the hood latches. Now you can paint those and attach them later. I'll attach them now and give them a little brush of black craft paint. I can fix any craft paint mistakes with my fingernail, And I don't want to risk trying to super glue these on at the end and ruining my, beautiful white paint job. So that is it. It's a little fiddly because it's an older kit. Some of these parts are very small and the small parts will have flash on them and stuff. So follow those instructions carefully. Make sure you take your steps slowly, as I always recommend, but it will go together and it will look nice. You can see the windshield fits on there beautifully and we're not gonna have any problems with that stuff. So at this point, I'm gonna wash my body and my hood. Otherwise, I'm not going to worry about the seats and stuff like that, but we're going to make sure we wash that body and our hood so we don't get any big fish eyes on the flat surfaces, and then we'll get it into some color.
Siempre. picaña. Yo te la traigo de Cupé, de Vega Baja y de Santurce, de todas partes de Puerto Rico. Esta bomba yo la dedico a toda mi gente de Puerto Rico, a la familia Fontané, allá en Cupé Alto y lo Mejía en Vega Baja. ¡Que goce!
¡Hey! Bomba, bomba, para siempre.
Bomba, bomba.
a quick look at what I've done so far on my Golden Hawk. I did it in the white tan interior and black scheme. Now, it's not an exact replica of the one that I saw, you know, Daisy using on the show. Of course, we can't do that with these decals. Also, I've done the interior and stuff a little bit different than that, but we'll get it nice and close. We'll get it to look the way I want it, which is that white and black with the gold look. Those tires came out awesome. You saw in the video, I tried by tapping it in white paint, and that didn't work. The letters on the insides are too far in on the curve, so I just used a white acrylic pencil or pen marker and put them on that way and then sealed everything down. Check out the sweet little chassis on this thing. We've got our exhaust, our drive shafts, the skid plates on, and those nice gold wheels with white letter tires. White letter tires just look so cool. Now, I dry brushed the engine with a little bit of silver gunmetal just to bring out the detail on it when you look at it in person, so it's not a black blob. But then I left the frame gloss black, and I left the fan and the generator all that black, so it does contrast on there. We've got the roll cage done, and I did put the fog lights on it, and I did them in yellow on mine. We've got the radiator left to install, the radiator hose, the air cleaner, the hood braces, which mine will be in black, the black bumpers, which match the black fender flares, which went on so nice it blew my mind. I can't believe how nice those just fit. I figured an older kit that's been molded a gajillion times would have a problem with these, but they just tap right up in there. They just go right in. And the gas cap installs easily. Everything in the interior. I did put the CB radio. I wanted it to be seen. I wanted, you know, there's not much going on the dashboard. That's why I kind of highlighted the dash gauges with the chrome and then the decals over it. Got our steering wheel in, got the shifter, got the four-wheel drive, got the parking brake, and then I attached the CB radio to the top of the grab handle. Left enough off the handle on the side that someone sitting in the passenger seat could still grab it. Did our seats in there, did of course the black flooring, and then left that all metal because that's what that is in the back anyways. I didn't carpet it. Got our spare tire carrier, got our tail lights in. Got those nice headlights in. I did do orange on the marker lights just to stand out and give some contrast, and did black on the hood latches. I did a black gasket around the windshield and then glued everything in. So it's been going very well. Now the chassis will go in without much of a fight. I mean, there it is. It's installed. You can see it looks nice. Gonna look pretty sweet on there. So I'm just going to attach the final pieces, glue the chassis in, put the spare tire on, put the roll bar on, and then I will be doing the Golden Eagle decals for sure on my model. So I'm gonna get that working right now, and when I come back, we'll have the final. Wrapping up this Wednesday video, we've got the reissue of MPC's 1/25th scale Jeep Golden Hawk, the special edition CJ5. It is a sweet little kit. I said in the beginning, you know, the engine assembly and stuff like that can be a little fiddly, but I was very, very pleasantly surprised that the frame went together well, the drivetrain, the fender flares went on so well. I was so surprised. When I put the kit together, the frame just pops right onto the bottom of the body. Now, I was worried that I'd do something wrong, that it sits so low over the tires, but I didn't. If you look at the box art, that rear tire is nearly touching the flare, and so is the front. So that's exactly how it's supposed to build up, which is kind of par for the course for those 80s Jeeps. When I looked at them online, they kind of sat squat over the tires, and Jeep people tend to put on much bigger tires than the fenders can actually hold, because most of these flashy looking ones are just mall crawlers, and if they accidentally drive over a dried worm, you'll hit their tire rub on the fender. So the kit looks awesome. Now, I like my white and tan scheme with the gold wheels, the sort of a Daisy Duke Jeep. I think it's really cool. And then I did my own touches. Instead of doing a tan interior, I left the bed area in the white metal with the nice tan seat. Did some black carpeting in the front, mounted the CB radio on the handle. And then the mirrors went on beautifully with a little bit of that gel super glue. The lights went together well. I did them in amber, so you'd be able to see them a lot easier. The bumpers went on, and in fact, even though the rear didn't really need a bumper, I was able to put that on there as a nice piece of trim work to kind of finish it off. The taillights go in easily. The taillights also make make up part of the hinge if you want the tailgate to work. But since I wanted to mount that spare tire on the tailgate, I didn't want anything falling down. I just used that. Now, the braces for the top, if you use it, I just use that hole for the CB antenna. We got our fuel cap on there. I used the older style wheel, but then painted it in silver and did our shifters and brake levers. So I really enjoyed the kit with this Golden Eagle theme. The gold wheels over the white is a really neat color scheme, and the decals laid down easily, didn't have to fight them at all. So they went down, though the rear decals, I did have to trim right by the taillights. They were much too long. They were supposed to wrap all the way around, but if you do that, you'd have to apply them and then put the taillights on later. And I just decided to trim them and have the trim end right at the taillight. You saw how I white lettered the tires. Everything went very easily on the kit. The glue join to the windshield that I created, since I never want to fold it, is strong enough that we can look underneath the Jeep and take a look at all the coolness on there. I think the white letter tires are almost a must on those desert dogs. It just brings the whole look with the white paint on my build all together. I enjoyed the kit quite a bit. Looking to see what other variations will come out with this. I hope they bring out the Golden Eagle. I would build this again just as that way, just so I could have Daisy's Golden Eagle Jeep on my collection there. So as always, I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this kit over before it was available so that I can get it on the channel. And now that it's arriving in stores, by the time you see this video, I will link in the description so you can snag yours or just grab it from your favorite retailer, whatever you prefer. And as always, when you build your models, build them your way. Use the decals. Put the blue decals on. Make it the Renegade Jeep, which they include the decals for. Do whatever you want with it, as long as you have a good time, because that's what this hobby is about, is enjoying yourself with the kits that you want to have. So I want to thank you all for watching the show, and I will see all of you at the next review.